Hello everyone, I'm Eric, and my topic is on the nature of wind force upwelling in Barrow Canyon. So first, we are talking about the Pacific original water in Atlantic Ocean. So this Pacific water is flows northward through the Bering Strait, and it has a profound impact on the Western Atlantic Ocean, and channeled by the bottom topography of the shelf, and is also influenced by the atmosphere forcing and seasonal presence of the sea ice. And this is the circulation of the Pacific original water in the Chukchi Sea. And we can see the water mainly channeled by two flows, which is the central channel and the Alaskan coastal current. And this is Barrow Canyon. The submarine canyon we are talking about. So why is Barrow Canyon so important? First, it is a biological hotspot, and it's not as its elevated nutrient concentration enhanced productivity rates and high benefit biomass. And at least 40% of the Pacific water is channeled into it. An energetic process that occurs in Barrow Canyon is the upwelling. It is known to trigger the phytoplankton blooms in the region warm Atlantic water, and upwell the winter water to the Chukchi Strait. Also, the wind force is the most common upwelling mechanism in Barrow Canyon. So, in this study, we want to solve the relationship between the currents and the water mass in the canyon, and how hydrography and fault are affected by the wind, the sea ice, and the polynya. Okay, so what is polynya means? Polynya is a lake surrounded by sea ice between the ocean. So this is a typically polynya. So the source of data we use basically are mooring data in the head of Barrow Canyon, and the weather stations data, the wind data from the Barrow wind weather station, and the satellite ice concentration data. So in this study, we use potential temperature salinity range for different water mass. The red color is the summer water, which is Alaska's coastal water and the Bering summer water, and the Atlantic water. The blues are the winter water. Mostly are the Pacific winter water. And we use the Barrow weather meta to complete the time integral of the wind stress over each upwelling wind event. Where is a long upwelling component of the wind stress, and TWS is the event is the start time of the wind event, and TWE is the end times of the wind event, and this tau is the wind stress, and T is time. Later, we got this chart. Those events are associated with upwelling. That we found that most upwelling seen are with the eye with bigger than and then this number, then and then we tabulate the TS characteristics of the water present of the peak of each upwelling event, then divide the result into cold season and warm season, and it reveals that. It reveals that there are many more events during the cold season than the warm season. And most of them are Pacific winter water. There are only a few Atlantic water. Then we tabulate the number of the days in a month that the ice concentration anomaly was negative, and compared it leads to the number of the upwelling days during the month. This reveals a clear relationship, such that more upwelling days are associated with less ice in the polynya region. Out of the events, only a few occur during the open water period, which means when there is no sea ice, there is less upwelling event occurred, and most are occur during the ice period, and most of them are Pacific water, which is green. And only a few of them are Atlantic. And the shade is the ice period. So this is our conclusion. There are more than twice as many upwelling events during the cold season as the warm season due to the seasonal winds. And strong storms tends to result in a stronger upwelling. Also, the strength of the upwelling response does not appear to be impaired by the presence of ice color. The less is upwelling typically correspond with the occurrence of the polynya. So this is my speech.
Do you think this paper can help us and how?
So how does this paper help us a lot? Basically, it helps us with the wind forcing upwelling events in our Taiwan Strait submarine crevasse. Because the geographical places are basically similar, like this you can see is the Taiwan Strait, and this is the Gaoping Submarine Crevasse, which is in Kaohsiung. And also, because we don't have a sea ice near Taiwan, so the sea ice part is not very useful in our research.
I want to know why you choose this paper.
Why I choose this paper is because I read it before in last semester.
Okay, I see. Yeah. Thanks.
I want to ask, what is the most important message you think this paper want to tell us?
Basically, the most important message for us is the wind forces is connected to the upwelling since the strong storms tend to result in stronger upwelling. That's, I think, the most important.
I want to know, how does the upwelling form here?
The the upwelling form usually by triggered by winds, and also the dense change of the water. Yeah.
And in this graph, there's a above. Can you explain generally why we have define the strengths of the wind, and also just explain it a little bit. Thanks.
Because the wind is not just move a period. It moves every time. So to understand the upwelling, we need to cut the wind straight during the upwelling tides, not just count lay out in our research.
Hi, I'm Yuki. I have a question about you have a page, one page you say that the at least 40% of Pacific Ocean. I want to know what the 40% mean.
So how the 40% of Pacific Ocean water means? This means the Barrow Canyon is the main channel to transport Pacific water to Atlantic water, to Atlantic Ocean. Yeah. So you can see mostly the water flows in Chukchi Sea, and at the end they all gather to Barrow Canyon, then move to Atlantic water ocean. So this is the main channel to the Atlantic water.
Because I don't see that part is the Atlantic Ocean. So it seems like this picture like all the water is from the Pacific, but you say at least 40% is means that this area has a symbol not only the Pacific Ocean water and other water like Atlantic water and other something. But I don't think that other 60% is from Atlantic water.
The fact is the paper, he said 40% is the estimate. In the observation, we actually found 80% to 100% of the Barrow Canyon's water is Pacific water. The 40% is just a roughly number to extend this currents.
The water is the whole layer or just the surface current?
It's a whole layer.
So it's a whole layer from the surface to the bottom, and the 40% is from Pacific.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
You have choose a very difficult paper, in my opinion, and considering that you have read it last semester, I think you haven't presented well, in my opinion. Let's check your research purpose. Where is it? Here. Okay. So here you said you want to study the relationship between this and that, and wind, and sea ice, and polynya. Where did you mention that you want to study upwelling? Here. Have you mentioned that? However, based on the result, because his paper has something like 15 figures, and I was really having headache when reading your papers yesterday. I really wonder which figure you would choose for your presentation. And at the end, the figure you choose for your presentation, many of them are related to like upwelling, right? And your conclusion is all regarding upwelling, but you didn't mention that in your purpose. So there is some inconsistency in your talk. That's the first thing. And then I also appreciate like you use short sentence and highlighted keywords. However, yellow is really a bad choice. Okay, like here, it's difficult to read the code easily when standing there. Use another color. And then it's good that you explain polynyas with a figure. That's a good choice. However, it would be really great. I think what you need most is to consider again what is the key point you want to present to the class, because this paper is sort of complicated. So if you decided to focus really on water mass below are my suggestion, first, here you show many different water mass, right? However, to me, this name has really no real meaning. It would be great, like you have a space here, right? You don't need an A here. You use the space to show the map again and use the text box of PPT to highlight where each water mass is. Because these water mass, they are strange to us. I don't know where they are, okay? And also considering this map, you also need to show a bigger map, right? Because Atlantic, where on hell is Atlantic compared to this location? You need to show the relative location of the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean to this Barrow Canyon. So show a larger map. And then regarding your results, you need to show a map showing all these water masses, and then it should be possible to show in this TS diagram how to identify upwelled water. Can you? How to identify upwelling, upwelled water here? So how do you identify upwelled water? How do you do that? By what? By which parameter? How do they? You need to figure that out. I'm not a physical oceanographer. You are. You want to be one, right? So you need to tell us how to identify upwelled water, right? Apparently here it says upwelled water, so it should be possible to identify upwelled water here, right? Then, usually for a class like this, this is totally unnecessary. This is not necessary. You only need to tell us when this number is higher, what does that really mean? When this number is lower, what does that mean? Not equation. I forgot after listening to your talk. Okay, then so far the results you showed have not really connected well. So you need to first show the water mass, then you need to tell us how to identify the upwelled water, and then you need to show you have shown the wind forcing, but in your introduction, you need to tell us the relationship between wind forcing and upwelling. You didn't do that. Then at the end, you can say, okay, the relationship between upwelling and sea ice. This has been done. Okay, therefore, in your conclusion, some of these are not supported by your results, so you need to be selective to your conclusion again to make sure your conclusion is supported by the results you show. Okay, I hope to see you improvement next time. Okay. Thank you. Good. We take